Hi, I'm Jing Moniz. Making you look beautiful is my goal. Spend your night with me as I give you beauty tips and make a difference in your life. This is the Jing Moniz Show. Hello everyone and welcome to Jing Moniz Show! Applause! Yes! Woo! Okay, so our guest for tonight is isa kong mga anak-anakan yan. From the time she started modeling, nung naging TV host siya, and then when she entered acting. Okay? Everyone, please welcome Femela Beranda!
Hi,
Fem! Hi, Fem!
Wow! Ang saya naman dito sa studio!
Diba?
Pwede mo mag-hangout dito every night?
Oo naman, pwedeng-pwede. Maraming show every night dito. Okay, so, well, a lot of people doesn't know that si Fem calls me dad.
Yes.
Bakit dad?
Eh kasi we started as pairs. Uh-huh. Our batch in the PMAP Professional Models Association of the Philippines, our batch is called mga Ters. Ters. Not Ters, sisters, but Ters.
As in jolog na jologs lang.
Yeah, so, and then si, ano, si Gray, syempre, started calling you dad. Yeah. Syempre lahat kami dad na.
Oo.
And in true aspect of a dad, Jing naman talaga is our dad. I remember kasi all the highlights of my life. Pakamayak naman ako dito, dad.
Kaya mo yan.
The aspects of my career like modeling, hosting, and TV, parang lahat ng start or lahat ng highlights, naaalala ko si Jing na malaking factor siya sa pagkapasok ko sa career na yun. I remember that, if you don't remember, like
go.
The first time I really sat down with you and really talked to you, and nakatatak pa rin sa akin yung sinabi sa akin ni Jing noon. Nag-shoot kami for a magazine, preview magazine, which was in Malate pa.
Oh yes, yes.
Remember,
yes.
That, remember shoot, that. The bridal shoot.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's sa loob lang.
Sa loob, yeah.
What do you call that? The editorial. Sa loob.
Yeah.
It's an editorial for
wedding
preview.
Issue. Yeah.
In a wedding issue, and sabi niya, ikaw bata ka, magaling ka, maganda ka. You can make it internationally. And from then on, I tried doing international commercial modeling na. So, parang si Jing yung nag-instill in my head that I can be an international commercial model.
How old are you at that time?
14.
14? Oh my God.
14. Kasi yun yung parang may... I used that headshot that we did, yung yeah. bridal na yun, for my set card, composite card, that really made my career, you know,
wow.
The modeling industry.
I'm so honored.
What do you call this, around Asia. So I started modeling in Hong Kong, Singapore, around Asia.
Pero di ba nag-ano ka rin, nag-Europe ka?
That was a shoot lang, but it was aired in China.
Oh, okay. For a Chinese...
Bata ko nun doon, ang ganda.
Bata ka pa rin naman.
Paano ba yung nakaganon lang ako?
Yan. Actually, yes.
Di ba? Pero payat lahat. Walang effortless.
Ganun talaga ang buhay. Dumarating yes. sa panahon.
Yes. Thank you, Dad. Pero yun, if you don't remember,
yeah.
thank you
actually,
for that. Because you really made me feel na kaya kong gawin to be an international commercial model.
Oh. Honestly, talaga. Actually, hindi ko natandaan yun. Ha. I didn't know that tumatak sa'yo yung
sinabi ko sa'yo. Naku, marami akong papaalala sa'yo.
Oh my God. Okay.
Thank you talaga for that because you really pushed me. Kasi at that time, the modeling industry was still, it wasn't this big yet. Parang
yeah.
parang it was like being an international model that time or commercial
deal,
model.
Talaga.
It's a big deal.
Yes. Oo. Okay. Wow.
Yes.
So ako pala nag-push sa'yo. Malis
yes.
ka na.
Yes.
Tignan nyo. Ang napupush ko. Okay, so Fem, another thing na hindi alam ng tao, nung minanage kita.
Yes.
So may kwento?
Oh my gosh, it was our biggest ordeal. Talagang nagkaroon kami ng gap ni Dad because of, you know how when you're close to someone and you become like business partners talaga, it's hard. But we overcome that and surpassed na namin yun. And we're closer now. Ayaw na ikwento.
Ayaw na ikwento mo! Kasi marami tayo pinagdaanan
that
time.
Kasi
that
time, it was...
Napaka-strict. Yung being strict ko sa inyo sa trabaho.
Mm-hmm. It was actually when I started doing showbiz. I started kasi with hosting with Channel
Extra
7.
Extra Challenge.
And it was actually... Iba yung nagbigay sa akin ng
yeah.
project, si Elan pa yun.
Yes.
Anyway, so when I transferred to ABS-CBN, it was Jing who handled me already because of I was going through a big ano na, yeah, controversy.
Yes.
And then so Jing was able to still salvage me from that controversy and gave me a standard in ABS-CBN, yes, na ito si Fem. Yes. Ayon sa gusto niyo makuha niyo. But through time nagkaroon lang ng misunderstanding, but now it's okay na. For that first few years in showbiz,
oh my God, hindi tayo nag-usap.
Oo, si Dad yung nag-set sa akin sa ABS-CBN. Yeah. That's all I can say. But after few years, yeah, nagkaroon lang kami ng nag-lost touch. Ganyan. lost touch lang naman. And then nakabalikan ulit.
Intact again, yes.
Oh, intact ulit. But again, in my showbiz career, I think it was Dad also who set my standards in ABS.
Wow.
Hanggang ngayon yung sinusunod namin na TF.
Dapat! Uy naman, natagal na yun. Natatang ang TF.
Diba, once you set kasi, yun na yun eh. And he was able to negotiate or
yeah,
talagang
mabigyan
akong...
Yeah, I put you on a higher rate. Talagang, hindi.
Ito yung
si
price
niya. Si Fem Miranda yan eh.
Yes.
Whether you like it or not.
It's because also you believed in us.
Of course. No, because I know you have the talent.
Yes.
You know, kahit... I also remember Fem, diba? Doon nag-host ka. Kinuha pa kita ng vocal coach.
Yes. I said, get in touch with Ampi.
Ampi, yes. So, kasi, syempre, like, parang ako, dati, si Fem, hindi ganun kagaling mag-host, pero sabi ko, Fem, let's get someone who can train you as a host. Diba?
So, until now, si Ampi ba yung vocal coach ko?
So, ngayon, since ako naman ang host.
Oh my gosh! Oo nga, Dad. I forgot. I thought I'm the host.
Yeah. Hindi, since ako naman ang host, anong advice ang mabibigay mo sa akin as a host? Mayos ka, ha?
Kunin mo si Ampi.
Same person, parang...
Kunin mo!
Kunin mo si Ampi.
Nagti-theater, I think.
Yes, oo.
Theater, and I think...
Yeah. She does also do soap. Uh-huh. And then she does theater acting. And then she teach people how to...
Or tawagan mo lang ako bago ka umere, tapos papagalitan na kita, ikaw ha, huwag ka munang umano.
Or sandali, ako hindi ako nalilate sa call time ko.
Yes!
Yun ang importante. Yun actually po, yun ang tinuro ko sa kanila, is always be early on the call time. Like, 30 minutes before the call time, nandun ka na sa set.
Like today, I'm an hour po, early. Oh,
yes, actually maaga. Actually, in fairness ha, ngayon maaga si Fem.
Maaga naman talaga.
Nagulat ako kasi... Hindi pa naman oras niya, pero nandito na siya agad-agad.
Yes.
So I'm so proud of you. At least ganyan napapractice mo na yung ikakasigaw ko siya sa telepono. Where are you? Wala ka na naman. Late ka na naman. Oh my God. Sigang, halos
kasi naman,
everything.
Dad, that time, wala pa akong pangbayad sa driver.
Sigaw mo ako, may driver ka na.
May driver pala ako.
Oo, bago nga yung kotse mo. Oh. Diba?
Okay.
Wala kang excuse sa akin.
Pero I think yun nga, Dad, now I realize, parang all the highlights of my starting point of my career pala. Andan ka. So, thank you.
Okay. So, why don't you share naman yung experience mo when you were modeling abroad?
Abroad, wow. It was really my... Kasi I really wanted to be a model. That yun talaga yung... It was my dream. I really wanted to be, an international model. Yeah. I actually wanted to be a fashion model. But I'm a bit... short, but it paved my way to be a commercial model naman.
Yeah, which is you
which
make
is
more money.
More money.
Yeah, exactly.
And I actually did a lot of regional commercials, meaning I'll shoot one commercial and it will be aired in five countries
in Asia. Yeah.
In Asia. And I was in high school or college, first year college till mga ganyan. So I'll be in Hong Kong. I'll come back to Manila to go to Thailand, to go to Singapore.
To shoot
so
for
it really,
a different project.
Yeah, it was really a very exciting and memorable time for me. And I was working with different production houses, may Thai, may Australian. I would go to Australia.
Yeah, I remember that you did a shoot the commercial in Australia.
Yeah, for Pantene, and then I would go to Tuscany.
Oh my God, that's so shy.
To drive a Porsche.
Wow.
Car brand.
Oh driver, yeah, that's the car
the
commercial. Beers. Oh,
sabi ko, Dad, pupunta ako ng Tuscany, malamig daw. Pwede akong mayroon ng coat.
Yes. Tsaka yung... pala yung mga turtlenecks.
My God, suot ko yung turtleneck mo, Dad, tsaka yung coat mo. I mean, imagine me wearing Jing's clothes.
Oh my God!
Kasi when I was still starting, I don't have that big closet, like, pang winter. Yeah. I only have pang tropical.
Uh-uh.
So sabi ko, Jinky ni Barrow, naka-peacoat ako na ganyan. Pero it was Jinx. And then my bag, I borrowed from my friend Grace,
Louis Vuitton naman.
Para mukhang social, right? Pagkita ko, may butas. Paano nabutas sa Louis Vuitton keep all? I don't know how, Grace. Grace Molina, I don't know how. Diba, the keep all leather, may butas. Ako, Grace, it's not my fault. Ah. But those were the days that I really enjoyed traveling, even if limited yung ano ka pa yung funds ko, walang pang shopping. May I had per diem, per diem. So I would spend it for
per diem.
Instead of eating, I would buy it na lang something ganyan. Pero
kasi mas syempre pang shopping na lang yun.
Yes. Sayang pero naman. Kung meron lang Instagram those din, nakakatawa na. Na Instagram ko na yung outfit ko by Jing Moniz.
Oh, just for the record, ha? Imagine yun, nagkasya si Femme.
Yeah!
Nagkasya si Femme sa damit ko. Ibig sabihin ho yun, model size.
Tsaka maliit pa yung boobs ko nun.
Yes. Ay! Oh my God! Ano ba natin sabihin yun?
Oo, kasi wala pa akong
sige,
ano,
pupunta tayo bello. Dyan. So, yung, okay, yung experience.
Wala pa akong belo.
Lord.
Kaya kasha yung turtleneck mo dito.
Kasi I remember, basta, for the record, extra small ako noon. Hanggang ngayon, ako ngayon small na lang.
Hanapin ko yung picture pag nahanap ko.
Actually, I think meron ako noon, pero nakatago na sa baon lahat.
Wala kasi yung Facebook pa noon.
Okay, so, ano yung mga struggle mo nang nag-model ka? Especially nung when you work, nung nag-work ka sa, ano, sa abroad.
Nabuntis ako.
Okay. Alam
sorry.
Mo, ito yun ha.
Kasi, nabuntis ako.
Okay. Kasi, dumunta na gumodel ka. Siyempre, pag uwi mo sa Manila, hindi ka naman namin nakikita na tumataba ka, lumalaki ka. Paano mo natago sa akin yun?
Kasi nga, Dad, I was always...
Tayo na magkasama tayo sa lahat ng trabaho mo.
But yun nga, I wasn't kasi a ramp model. So you don't see me naman that often. Kasi like Grace or like Wilma, they did ramp, so they were always around you guys. So my excuse that time, I was always out of the country. Yeah. So I'll go to the States lang and try modeling there or vacation. And I stayed there for...
How many months did you stay?
4 months.
4 months?
So, no, because I made todo my... What do you call that when you enter? So 6 months.
So inubos mo lang 6 months?
Yeah, I think I was 3 months going 4 months.
When you left? You were 3 months pregnant already. Wow.
Yeah, going 4 months. So I stayed, so my mom... asked me to hide it first because it was my height of my modeling
how old
career.
Are you at the
time? 18.
18.
So I gave birth 19. I was 19. And then I came back and then I just said that I just had a vacation in the States because it's my first time. But I was 19,
I hope naman first time mo lang nabuntis yun, no?
No, my first time to go to the States.
Okay.
And I was 19, so my body bounced back to like,
parang walang nangyari.
Walang nothing happened. Yeah. But yun nga, of course, I had to, you know, hide it. But I went back to school, I went back to modeling, parang wala nangyari.
Pero is it difficult to model abroad?
Actually, yes. Well, for me kasi I had a hard time in Hong Kong. Because I stayed in a model's apartment for a while without my mom, and I'm not that I'm very sheltered, so parang I'm senorita at home, so I'm not used to like sharing an apartment with these Caucasians, and they're a bit bitchy, so parang
I remember. So we have the same agency, Mien
Stars.
Yes, Mien. Yes.
Yeah, so it's hard to blend also. In, and then in Hong Kong, if you say you're Filipino, sometimes they
look down.
And then may nangligaw sa akin na ano, somebody courted me, a big star.
Ayun, okay, kwento mo yan.
Big star in Hong Kong that time.
Sino to? Sino tong big star na to?
No, Leon Lai. Anyway, parang he's like the Gary Valenciano of the Philippines daw.
Of Hong Kong.
And then, of Hong Kong, something like that. And then, of course, pupunta ko sa house nila, the house help is Filipina. So, okay naman, parang I got to talk to her, and then Leon Lai naman, that's why he's very pala with Filipinos because his house help is Filipina. But it's hard lang because I'm away, and I was still young. But I think nowadays it's easier because there's Instagram, there's Facebook,
Skype,
Viber, WhatsApp. You can get in touch.
So it's easy to connect.
Yeah, when I was in Hong Kong. Anong gagawin ko? Wala na akong ano.
Long distance. Wala,
wala akong
distance.
Money pang tawag or pang text.
Long distance ang tawag doon.
Yeah. So I don't want to use my my roaming.
Yung extra money.
Yeah. Now it's easy enough for them. I'm sure there are so many ways to
connect.
To be connected.
But when you were casting in a commercial, always bang meron silang pinapa, bago ka pumunta ng casting, your agent, Mian, na, oh, you have to be on this character. May ganun
no,
ba sila?
No. That time kasi it was really the, I think they want a blank, blank
canvas. So when
canvas
you go casting,
look,
wala ka makeup?
Nothing. Almost nothing. It's just, siguro, concealer and blush on. And then, ganda lang.
Ganda lang. Parang ngayon.
Yeah.
Ngayon lang.
No, I think they really ngayon wanted kasi clean ponytail hair.
Raw. Yes.
So, I really milked it out. And then, after noon, wala na.
So, tapos nung bumalik ka sa Manila and you focused your modeling career in Manila, you were with PMAP, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And then you were become a president of PMAP.
Yes. My God, after how many years? So, when I came back to the Philippines, when I was in college now, that's the time I was able to do a lot of ramp shows with PMAP.
With PMAP.
Yeah. And then after 5 years pa yata or 10, I don't know how many years na gap, that's when I became the president of PMAP. And then under my term was the 25th anniversary, which was a big celebration because we're a non-profit organization and it's so hard to produce a show without
any fans,
without any budget. But we were able to celebrate it, and
I remember that.
They be
it was
able
really
to
good, actually. Congratulations
Thank
on that
you.
Event.
They be able to continue the legacy of PMAP. Mm-hmm.
So. Okay, so do you have any advice for mga inspiring models?
For the inspiring models out there, just go for it. Just do. Just be aggressive on your castings, on your what do you call this? VTRs. Go lang nang go.
Yes, okay.
And always build your portfolio. Sometimes don't
do
get
test shoot.
Don't get tamad or don't get lazy. I already have a headshot. Just build your portfolio. And nowadays, my God, you can even shoot yourself with a phone or whatever and edit it and make your own website, your own blog.
Yeah. Yes, true.
There's so many ways now. So I think it's a lot easier now to what do you call this? Spread your network.
Kaya na, so mga inspiring models.
Spread your
network.
Narinig nyo
si Fem, si Femela Baranda, yung advice nila sa inyo. How you prepare yourself if you want to get into modeling industry. Okay?
Yeah, or get out of your comfort zone.
Yes, okay. So, from after modeling, di ba, you moved to being a host.
Yes.
Yes. Right? So, kamusta naman yung hosting mo? Kamusta yung first ever hosting job mo?
My gosh, I think it was, I forgot what beauty pageant was.
Miss Earth.
Miss Earth? My gosh!
Di ba alam ko? Kasi ako nag-book
sa
iyo noon.
So, parang... Parang yung salita ko. And we're next, thank you. So I really don't remember what I said, how I said it. Ang sabi lang sa akin ni Direct Robbie Carmona, ano ba yan, fame? Practicein mo naman yung lines mo.
Oo, may cue card ka kasi nga nun, binibigay sa'yo bago ka lumabas.
So after that, I try to, of course, every time I go out naman and do those things, I still get nervous, I still get anxious, I still get stressed out or pressured, but what you do is you do something about it. You practice, you read through, you do verbalization or something, or shake your body.
Set your body para ma-relax.
So I learn how to prepare and overcome my what do you call this, nervous.
Well, kasi, actually, alam ko yung nararamdaman. Kasi nararamdaman ko yun. Yung nararamdaman
diba,
ko.
But after, once you get started na, and you're rolling.
It takes a lot of practice
talaga.
Yeah,
practice.
And then after modeling, diba, after hosting, you try to do movies.
Yes.
And yeah, what was your first
movie? My movie and TV career didn't take off because...
Nakakatawa yun, diba? Nakakatawa yung sinabi niya, my first movie hindi nag-take off.
Hindi masyadong take off ang aking movie and TV, as an artista, because I was busy hosting.
Okay, so anong movie yun?
Hi! Leading man ako ni, Lino. Lino. Dito Lapid.
Leading man ka? Oh my God! Oh my God! Okay, now ngayon pa na-confirm na natin. Leading man po si Feb.
Sorry. Leading man ko si Lito Lapid.
Did kaya pala, oh,
trivia! What movie is that?
Kaya pala lumaki yung boobs mo kasi kasi ka
leading man. Anong movie yun? No, it was ano?
Oh my God.
Tatlong Baraha. Oh, Baraha. The remake.
Oh. Oh, hanapin niyo na 'yan. Panoorin niyo na 'yan.
Well, but actually, yun nga, I was already busy with my hosting with TV Patrol and The Boss.
Yes.
That it was so hard for me to book.
Yeah. Like a movie
acting,
or so the tape gigs regularly.
Because galing ko pa naman daw. Baka may chance pa ngayon.
Pero di ba may ginawa ka with Aga Mulak ba?
Madami. I mean, I get to do kasi yun nga lang may cut off. Like I have to leave at 4 or 5.
Kasi meron ka patrol.
Yes. Uh-huh. And then Saturdays lang yung shoot or mga ganun. But it was so...
Pero honestly, mas better ka lang host kaysa actor.
Oo. Maganda na. No, I actually...
Ilalagag na kita, pero
I actually enjoyed this indie film. I did an indie film called The Heritage or Ang Pamana. Okay. It's produced by Romeo Candido and the whole team. They're a Filipino-Canadian. So they really enjoyed doing that indie film naman.
Okay. So now, ito. Mm-hmm. Meron akong game para sa iyo.
Okay, I love games. Okay, may prize.
Ang prize sa game, makeover kay Jing Moni sa
Oh, Dad, you're so busy. Hindi na kita nakikita.
Okay. Ang tawag sa game na ito ay Imodel. Mo ito.
I-model ko.
I-model mo ito! Ah! Okay.
Where is my camera? This one?
Ito yung camera mo. Ah. Yan ang camera mo. So, magbibigay ako ng mga produkto or mga situation na kailangan i-project mo.
Okay.
Now, let's start! Are you ready?
Si Wilma! Si Wilma yung kasama.
Dito natin mag-test agaling dito yung Miranda as a model. Okay? Okay, una. High fashion shoot. Couture! Couture, ha? Ngayon, nagmo-model ka ng toothpaste! Toothpaste? Ngayon, nagmo-model ka ng shampoo!
Wala ka na, Dada. Wala.
Shampoo! Oh, ayan. Hair... Oh! Ganda yun! Bigla tayo nagmo-model ng deodorant!
Deodorant!
Deodorant sa tele! Ayan! Deodorant!
Wait, nalibasa.
Paano deodorant?
Okay.
Sweat! Okay. Bigla ka lang bola ng liquid detergent. Class,
ano
liquid
yun?
Detergent. Yan, sosyal. Nakapose! Nakapose! Sanitary napkins. Gusto ko yan! Oh my God! Sanitary! Diba? You can move. Bigla ka lang bola ng Dulcolax. Okay, eto. Funeral homes!
Yun yung pinakamahirap kaya sa edad eh.
Kaya mo ng funeral homes! Okay, we'll be right back of Femmehenna after this break!
Aral, saan ka dahil?
Hi guys, it's me, Tita K!
Tita K!
Come and hang out on Live Love Lols. Let's talk about makeup, beauty.
Hi, ganda.
Who's that? We can talk about ugly too. Nah, just kidding. And of course, Donya problems galore. Yaya, ang spaceship paki on. Fashion, shopping. Oh my God, shopping! I love shopping. Ah, food. We gotta talk about food. Anything and everything on cyberspace. Let's buy everything. We can talk about glamour and ubusan ng glamour. We fly Wednesday 6 to 7 p.m. only on nmfnetwork.tv.
Okay, now we're back again. Okay.
Pwede na ba 'yon? Pwede pa ako mag-commercial.
Okay, gusto niyo ba nagustuhan niyo ba yung modeling moment ni Fem Veranda? Okay. Okay, Fem. Let's talk about Nicole.
Okay.
So naitago mo na siya sa akin for so many years.
Yes.
Na, you know, we constantly nagkikita tayo parate at tapos nag-usap tayo pero wala kang binabanggit sa akin tungkol kay Nicole.
Mm-hmm. Well, so, syempre that it was very hard for me then and not just for me but my whole family. But my mom passed away and that really was a very painful event or a situation in my life. So after noon, I really stood up and took full responsibility of Nicole. So parang ayoko nang ulit-ulitin na yun nga, tinago ko siya. Or ano,
patatagalin mo pa siya.
Yeah. So, I mean, now I'm just really doing my best and my all to catch up and to tell the whole world about her.
And be a mom to her.
And I think, ano nga eh, napabilis masyado. Parang I only told the whole world last November. And then, now, last April, she entered PBB because nakita siya ng mga taga-PBB. Sabi na, why don't you ask her to audition? Mm-hmm. She really auditioned for that because she wanted it. She wanted to experience the showbiz. And
how do you feel about that? That she's entering showbiz now?
Of course, at first, I was excited for her because she's gonna come out of her shell. But after seeing all the bashers, yung mga comments ng bashers, syempre masakit, parang wag na lang kaya. But I will still, consider it. But now, I really want her to go back first to school. Hmm. So, nasa ano pa kami, work in progress pa yung mga, marami pa kami pag-uusapan. Kung kaya na ba niya, gusto ba niya, anong pang gusto niyang gawin. Kasi right now, she made a lot of followers. Marami na siyang followers sa PBB.
So, but giving a choice, would you actually allow Nicole to enter show business?
I think like, you know, 1 foot in na rin naman siya. So, I actually, while she was inside PBB, kasi wala silang social media, I was the one who's very active, connected and active to the followers. So, kung may bashers, marami rin siyang followers. And I think she already built an army. May mga Nicole army, Nicolesters, Kiminis. So, I wanted to keep them, but I just want her to know that it's an option.
Yeah. Pero hindi ka ba natatakot na since she entered show business? Siyempre ngayon, magkakaroon ng mga love team yan, pag gumawa ng movie or teleserye.
Actually, the love team is okay pa nga for me kasi I know naman, nasa teenager naman niya, may mga ano na yan. On the side na rin na. So, as long as nababantayan ko naman siya, and I think I have...
You guide her properly.
I guide her properly. And she's allowed to commit mistakes. She's allowed to experience things. But learn from it.
Hmm. Actually, it's nice actually when you actually make a mistake.
Yes.
And then you learn from it. Kasi that makes you a better person. Eh.
Yes.
Diba?
Yan naman yung natutunan niya kay Big Brother, kay Kuya. Yeah,
kay Kuya. So, anong advice mo ngayon kay Nicole?
I call her Kimmy. Kilala
yeah,
mo siya.
Yeah, I know. Actually,
kaya
hindi
ako
sanay
ko
sa kanya
eh.
Na tinatawag siya Nicole kasi I know Nicole as Kim.
Kim Nicole mula kasi, the full name.
Pinakala siya sa amin ni Fem, si Kim siya.
And Kim. I think they chose Nicole because there's a Kim Chuna.
Uh-oh.
Yun, I'm always here for Kim. I'm always here for you, Kim. And basta alalanin mo na lahat ng alam ko.
Ayoko umiyak.
I mean, lani mo, nandito ako lahat ng mga pagdadaanan mo. Napagdaanan na namin yan.
Yes.
Andiyan ang dadjing mo.
Yes. Alam mo yan, Kim.
Andiyan si Ate Wilma, Tita
I'm
Wilma. Andiyan yung mga yan to guide you. Mm-hmm. And we're just here for you.
And si Kim, member siya ngayon ng Jing Mo. Yay! Diba?
Really?
Kim. Please, kung meron, like what I did to your mom, I guided her when she was starting modeling and hosting.
Yay!
I will do the same thing to you.
Yay! Okay? Thank you.
Okay. So now, Fem, you have to help me. Well, actually, ito yung introduce namin sa inyo, yung aming second winner ng makeover.
Woohoo! Okay? Kala ko ngayon may makeover.
My God, no makeover na kita, matagal na. Okay, so ngayon, excited na ba kayo? Makita si Bem Sayas. Okay?
Woo-hoo!
Bem is a second year college, back in school. She's back in school now. So, what she did a selfie and posted, and now she's the winner of the makeover. Hi, Bem!
Hi, Bem!
This is Pam.
Hi, how old are you?
17.
Wow.
17?
Yes. Perfect. Wow. Okay. Perfect talaga, para may debut.
So you're on second year college na?
Yes po.
Oh. And anong course mo?
Naksamang
basas mo, girl.
Bachelor of Science in Customs Administration.
Dog, she reminds me of the daughter of Lala.
Diba? That's why I was telling her, kamakaya si Ika, yung supermodel. Mm-hmm. Ganyan na ganyan yung tsura.
Super kamakaya.
Kumayat ka lang palangkot. Dahil kamukha mo na siya. So tell me, bakit mo nag-decide kang mag-selfie and send it to us? Like, how are you ba growing up?
Nung, mag-selfie.
Like, nung bata ka, ayan, selfie na tayo.
Ganda, yeah. Diba?
Okay. So, like, you nung bata ka sa eskwelahan, nung mas bata ka pa, kasi bata ka pa. Ano ba ito sinasabi ko? Kasi bata pa siya. 17 years old. Okay, so, nung bata ka, mas bata ka, nung high school ka or grade school ka, ano ba yung normally mong itsura?
Hindi po ganito, hindi po ako nag-aayos, or something na nagli-lipstick ngayon, nagli-lipstick na po ako.
Natuto ka na. Oo. So, ano ka ba dati, boyish?
Anong hair mo? Curious lang.
That, anong, gano'ng kahaba yung buhok mo ba? Nung gano'ng kalaking tinanggal nila sa'yo?
One inch
okay. lang. Pero, ang style ng buhok mo, hindi ganito.
Hindi po.
So, kulot ang buhok mo, di ba?
Yes, sobra.
So,
okay.
Ngayon, gusto mo na bang straight hair?
Yes.
Parang
po.
Pang shampoo commercial lang. Di ba? So, happy ka ba sa result ng makeover mo?
Yes, super happy.
Yes! Yay! So, sino ba nag-makeover sa'yo sa Greenbelt, sa Jing Money Salon? Hindi mo matandaan pangalan? Ikaw naman. Ayaan mo na. O, sige. Anyway, congratulations, Bem. I hope, hindi lang ngayon, nakikita ka namin ganito, but I hope pagpasok mo sa school, importante na ganito parating ayos mo.
Yes.
Okay? So, keep this look kasi ito na ang start of your new life. Okay?
Support ka namin dyan.
Oo, support ka namin
dyan. Fam and Bam! Yay!
Okay. So, everyone, if you want to win a makeover like Bam, please do a selfie and then post it and tell us why you deserve a makeover. Okay? This is for male and female. So, hindi lang po mga boys dyan. So, tingin nyo, you deserve a makeover. All you have to do is do a selfie, tell us why you deserve a makeover, and then post it, tag Jing Money Show, tag NMF TV, tag Beauty Trendsetter. Okay?
Yay.
And then, we would like to thank our sponsors! Okay, I would like to thank Nix Alano of Phoenix Home for a beautiful couch.
Ay, akin na raw yung throw pillow.
Yeah. Okay, Phoenix is located at 6075 Palma Street, Poblacion, Makati with telephone number 901-4144. And of course, I would like to thank Dr. Ivy Teo. Thank you! Lumilisit na mukha ko, Doc! Alam mo yan. And of course, always visit Jing Money Salon. It's located at Greenbelt 1 on the 3rd floor in Bellevue Hotel in Alabang. We also have in Maxim's in Resource World, Hair Philosophy by Jing Money Salon at Salcedo Street. We have Famous Salon in Green Hills, in Connecticut, Robinson's Ermita, Glorieta 5, and SM Pampanga. Okay, till next week, please watch the Jing Money Show! Bye, everyone!
The views and opinions expressed on any program are those of the persons appearing on the program and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the New Media Factory. Some programs on this network might include strong images and language and may not be suitable for all audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.